Hello everybody. This lecture on special electrical machines, on special electrical machines of a two-phase hybrid stepper motor. We're having a five-phase hybrid stepper motor also. Then let's go for what about the hybrid stepper motor and what about the two-phase also. Next, in this content space, we are having that introduction. What is the hybrid stepper motor, hybrid control systems, open loop control system, closed loop control system, and also comparison of stepper motors, advantages and disadvantages and applications. Here, if you observe, all the motors convert electrical power, that is volts and amps, into mechanical power, torque and speed. All the motors, any one of the motor, that is an induction motor or a synchronous motor or a DC motor, not about the depend upon the supply of the system, AC or DC supply, but all the motors convert electrical power, volts and amps, into mechanical power, torque and speed. Here, the unique feature of the stepper motors is that they can be very accurately controlled in terms of the speed and rotation angle. That is the importance of the stepper motors. Why we are going to discuss about the introduction again means here, before going to discuss about the hybrid stepper motor, here, how many classification, how many types of stepper motors are having, how to know. That we are also know actually, that is a variable reluctance stepper motor, permanent magnet, and also the hybrid. But before going to discuss about these, first we have to observe the these are having, motors are having nothing but, what about the applications of motors, for any motors. That is, the unique feature is to be, the speed is to be controlled, speed is controlled very accurately. That is, what I discussed about, that is precision control, speed and rotation angle. What about the required angle should be getting, that it can be getting from the stepper motor only. Therefore, stepper motors are brushless DC motors and as such require an electric driver to commutate the windings. Commutate, what is meant by commutate? The commutate means to turn off, to switch off. Okay, nothing but to off the some period, to turn off some period of time towards the current, current towards the coil. That is nothing but the commutate the windings of the coils. Electronic driver is to be required. Nothing but an electronic commutator here we are using. Nowadays, most of the time, most of the applications are using with electronic commutators only, not with mechanical commutators, are also called conventional. Conventional commutators are different, electronic commutators are different. Electronic commutators require switching, nothing but requires switching pulses or switching circuit through logic family, logic circuits. Okay, what we observed in the control system of a truth table, that is nothing but either if you consider a four-phase winding, therefore for the four-phase winding, each phase can be having with the two switches. Therefore, total 8 switches we are having. Sequence, in a sequence manner, in every time, two switches can be operated. Okay, that is the thing. And next one, in order to control the rotation, electric pulses are input into the driver and the motor rotates one step for each pulse. The excellent stability of the motor results in a simple control circuit since the motor can be run open loop and no feedback is required. What about this point means here, if any motor, nothing but any type of the stepper motor, if you consider, the rotation angle can be properly, nothing but actually the motor is operating the loads, that it should be depend upon the load and also depend upon the horsepower of the type of the motor we have placed, kilowatt range. If the load can be operated, okay, if the required rotation angle is something, this is nothing but 7.2 degrees, suppose. The required rotation angle of the rotor is to be 7.2 degrees, suppose. Therefore, if the rotor is operating for each pulse of a 7.2 degrees, what should be happen? That it is a stable one. Nothing but the motor is operating in a stable manner. That is nothing but excellent stability of the motor results in a simple control circuit. Nothing but there is that type of motors not required any closed loop system. That is required only open loop. That is enough. Okay. That is the point of this one. The excellent stability of the motor results in a simple control circuit, since the motor can be run open loop and no feedback is required. Actually, there are three types of stepper motors, that is variable reluctance, permanent magnet and hybrid stepper motors. We discussed about the variable reluctance motor and the modes of operations, and also about the permanent magnet motors also. Okay, here if you consider that is explain the four phase variable reluctance stepper motor operation. If they are within the examination, they will ask like this, four phase, okay. Yes, you have to draw four phases. Okay, four poles means four pair of poles. Total 8 poles in the stator. Okay, like that, you have to write the exam, the question, answer. Okay, like that. Next, what about the hybrid stepper motors? This is very important. Hybrid stepper motors is very important. Why? Because the hybrid stepper motor is a combination of a variable reluctance motor and also the permanent magnet motor, permanent magnet stepper motor. Okay, a hybrid stepper motor is a combination of the variable reluctance and permanent magnet type motors. The rotor of a hybrid stepper motor is actually magnetized like a permanent magnet stepper motor, and the stator is electromagnetically energized like a variable. Nothing but these two are considered from the construction point of view. The hybrid stepper motor is designed with respect to stator from the variable reluctance stepper motor and the rotor from the permanent magnet stepper motor. Therefore, the hybrid stepper motor consisting of electromagnetic poles on the stator, and the rotor is consisting of permanent magnet. Okay, that is the importance of the construction. Next one, both the stator and the rotor are multi-toothed. Both the stator and rotor are multi-toothed. Multi-toothed means if you consider the stator is also having the number of two teeth, and also the rotor is also having the number of two, like that. That is nothing but the multi-toothed. A hybrid stepper motor has an axially magnetized rotor, meaning one end is magnetized as an north pole and the other end is a south pole. Toothed rotor cups are placed on each end of the magnet, and the cups are offset by half of the toothpick. If you observe in the diagram also, this is nothing but the rotor. This is the rotor of a permanent magnet. You consider it is a permanent magnet. Okay. Next, if you consider this a stator, this is nothing but the stator. The stator is consisting of total how many poles? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, up to 8. Okay. Totally, we are having that 8 poles. That is nothing but 4 pair of poles. With respect to the 8 poles, we are having that 8 poles, we are having that 4 pair of poles. Okay, here the coil is to be connected here of all the stator poles. Nothing but the field poles are wounded with the coil, that is the copper winding has been placed. Therefore, here if we observe, the stator is also having so many number of tooth. If you observe on the stator field pole shoe, if you consider, there is having number of tooth on the stator. Nothing but if you consider all the poles, n number of poles, with n number of poles is each pole having that number of tooth, suppose 6, n into 6, like that. Okay. Therefore, with respect to this type of design, there is an accurate speed control is possible. The accurate speed control. Nothing but what I am told you about that 7.2 degrees is the required step angle, then there is a possibility to get an exact value of 7.2 degrees for each and every switching pulse applied. Okay, like that, the rotor is rotating. That is the importance of the hybrid stepper motor. This is nothing but the hybrid stepper motor. Not all the motors are not given like this design. Okay, like this design. Here also shown the diagram. This is the same. This is the stator, and within the part, internal part, there is given with the rotor. And come to the point of a control system. Control is important. Why? Because it is either open loop or it is closed loop. Why? Because what exact value of the speed is to be controlled? What exact value that it can be produced, or the torque value can be produced by the motor to run the load? That is also very much important. Therefore, the position of the motor is always monitored. The position of the motor is always monitored, and then the driver automatically switches between the two types of. Okay. Two types of controls depending on the situation. Once again, I'm telling the important point. The position of the motor is always. You observe, always monitored. Then the driver automatically switches between the two types of the points depending on the situation. Nothing but under normal circumstances, the operation of the motor is monitored and control is applied using open loop like a standard stepper motor. Nothing but if you observe a standard stepper motor, that it comes under open loop control system. Open loop control system has been applied. Nothing but there is no requirement of a positioning sensors, but always input pulse command will be given. But here we are facing a positioning sensor also. Positioning sensor also, therefore, under normal circumstances, the operation of the motor is monitored and control is applied using an open loop. This is the open loop system. If you observe, this is the motor. The motor is connected with a sensor. The sensor has been placed. This sensor always monitors. That is a constant monitoring. Always monitors the motor speed and also the torque value. The torque value can be determined from the current also. Okay, but it should be observed from the speed only. Nothing but at what displacement initially and after the signal switching pulse given, at what displacement, like that, and the rotation step angle can also be given. Nothing but if you observe, for any motor, a stepper motor, the revolution for complete one revolution, how many number of steps, if you consider, suppose it should be a 100 steps, or suppose if you consider 3.6 degrees is the step angle and 100 steps for considering of taking off one revolution to complete rotate. Okay, therefore, if you observe that under normal circumstances, the operation of the motor is monitored and control is applied using open loop. Therefore, excitation sequence control has been given towards the output component. Therefore, here towards this, what should be happen? An input counter signals has been provided towards the excitation sequence control. Excitation sequence control means, what about the stator coils are having? Through that stator coils, with respect to the stator coils, the excitation has been provided, that it can be given by the counter. Okay, and next one, deviation counter is also provided here. Next one, rotor position counter. Therefore, here from the sensor, two signals has been fed to the feedbacks towards the rotor position counter and also the deviation counter. From the input pulse, these two are deviated from the input counter and also the deviation counter. Again, another reference is also compared. If any deviation has been taken place, therefore giving signals towards the switch. Okay, nothing but these are the signals moving towards the excitation sequence control only. Okay, but if not any deviation means, this certain block is not operating. This is in a switch off position. If any further deviation occurred, that is sensed by the sensor, therefore a deviation has been there, then signal has been going towards the thing switch, okay, towards this column. Therefore, from these signals, the excitation sequence has been changing. Next one. Next one about the closed loop control system. About the closed loop control system, here if you observe the closed loop system, if any error occurs between the command and also the motor position due to a load or a system, due to a load, if suppose if the load is changed, if the load is suddenly changed, therefore what should be happen? The torque value can be changed. Okay, torque value can be changed. What about amount of current that is drawn by the motor from the supply system, okay, is changed. Whenever the torque is changed, means automatically that should show shown on the current value. Okay, that like that, if any error occurs, that the error can be determined from the sensor only. Here we are placing again the sensor. Same, the sensor has been given that the motor is connected with the sensor again. The sensor has been always senses the value and feedback towards the again rotor position sensor counter and also the deviation counter, same as the input counter. But what should be the difference here? Correction of the motor position. In the previous slide, there is no like this, nothing but there is no correction. Okay, here if you consider, here if you observe that if any rotor position counters has been there, okay, that is always sensed by the sensor and fed back towards the excitation sequence counter control. Okay, if an error occurs between the command and the motor position due to the load or the lag, or the system immediately switches to closed loop control. Okay, up to that point, the motor is running with the open loop control system only. After that, the motor should be rotating at the, with respect to the closed loop system. Okay, nothing but with respect to these type of situations, if any corrections are there, okay, nothing but corrections are there means examples of maintaining the speed, maintaining the torque, okay, like that. If any corrections are there, that it can be corrected by the motor itself by using of a feedback signal. Okay. Here, this corrects the position and speed, maintaining the desired operation. The combination of these two control methods ensures high reliability and performances. Nothing but these two are the loop systems which are provided for under normal operating conditions of the first one, and for the closed loop, if you consider if any overload operations is also there, overload operation situations are occurring at this moment, this closed loop control system can be occurred. Next one, what about this one, high response? Here, by utilizing this high responsiveness of the stepper motor, moving a short distance for a short time is possible. The motors can execute commands without lag. Without lag means there is no delay. There is no delay. That is nothing but these all the motors are operating with respect to the time manner. Within seconds, nothing but for complete one revolution, how many minutes of time should be required? For 100 steps of revolution of the rotor for complete one revolution, therefore how much time it should be required? That's why for any short time interval of operations are also there, these type of motors are, they will work more effectively. That is nothing but a response from the motor is to be very high, accurate. Okay, that is nothing but that motors can execute commands without lag. From the power drive circuit, always the signals are moving towards the motor. Okay, power drive circuit is nothing but a switching circuit. The switching circuit is always getting signals from the either logic family or the JK flip-flop or counters, if you consider counters, from this electronic circuit towards the power drive circuit. From the power drive circuit, supply nothing but the switches are switching pulses are giving towards the gate controls. From towards the gate controls, whenever the gate control is turned on and turned off is happening, means with respect to the sequence of operation, therefore the switches are becoming towards turn on and also the turn off positions, like that. Here if you observe, how operates synchronously with respect to the command. This is nothing but the response, effective response, okay? Operates synchronously with commands, with respect to the commands. Here if you observe, pulse command, this is actually the pulse command. This is the pulse command, means if you observe, the pulse command is to be having that, this is the turn on time period. If you observe, the pulse can be turned off here. Okay, the same, the motor output is also getting here, nothing but motor operation is also same like this. Okay, this is nothing but the positioning completion of the signal. This is nothing but, okay, nothing but accurate time period with respect to the pulse command given by the switching circuit, with respect to that circuit only the pulse is getting from the circuit, the motor can be operated on the same manner, on the same way, okay, without any deviation of the time. At that instant only that it should be on, motor can be operated like that. That is nothing but the response, high responsiveness. Next one, holding the stop position without hunting. Here, during position, the motor steps with its own motoring force without hunting. Hunting means, you all are also know that hunting. Hunting means oscillations. Oscillations are getting due to the torque, due to the overload capacity of that particular motor. Nothing but if the load is, suppose it is in a constant manner, there is no problem. Therefore, stable torque can be provided by the motor. But if the load has been changing with respect to the time period, if the load is also changing somewhat, therefore, whenever the load is changing, means automatically the torque is also changing. Therefore, the force required is also changing. Therefore, here it is saying, telling about that holding the stop position without hunting means without any oscillating manner. The rotor cannot oscillate furtherly. Nothing but if the rotor is started at a 0 degree, after 2 degree is the rotation step angle. Up to that point, the rotor can be become to hold position or stop position. The rotor cannot deviate. Deviate means do not get any hunting phenomena. That is, do not any getting oscillations. That is the important of hunting. Here, because of this, it is an ideal for applications where the low rigidity of the mechanism requires absence of vibration upon stopping. Next one, tuning free. Because it is normally operated with open loop control, positioning is still possible without gain adjustment, even when the load fluctuates due to the use of a belt mechanism, that is a chain brake. Okay. Positioning is still possible without gain adjustment even when the load fluctuates due to the use of the belt mechanism. This is the most important one. Next one, continuous operation even with the sudden load fluctuation and sudden acceleration. Continuous operation is possible. That is, it operates synchronously with commands using open loop control, during normal conditions, in an overload conditions. It switches immediately to closed loop control to correct the position. Nothing but we discussed about the two operating modes of control system, that is normal and also the overload. Normal operating means it is in a stable manner. Overload means actually it should be changing from normal to overload condition. At this moment, closed loop control, the system can be given with a feedback signal. Open loop is also giving the feedback, but there is no uncorrectiveness. There is a possibility of uncorrectiveness. But here, with respect to the high responsiveness of the motor, there is a correctness is possible by using of a closed loop system. Therefore, that is nothing but the point. It operates synchronously with the commands using open loop control during normal conditions. In an overload condition, it switches immediately to closed loop control to correct the position. Next one, what about the torque angle characteristics? What is that is nothing but we always observe that is torque versus current. Okay, torque versus speed characteristics. But here we are observing that the torque angle characteristics. Okay, why we are going through this torque angle characteristics means here with respect to the step angle only, with respect to step angle or the angular displacement of the rotor only, the motor is also getting the torque. Okay, that's why we consider this point, sir. Here on the x-axis, if you observe, there is a drawn step angle has been considered up to 7.2 degrees. Here, 1.8 degrees is also considered. The step angle is 1.8 degrees, 0 to 1.8 degrees. Okay, here it is a clockwise direction and it is the opposite clockwise direction. That is a counterclockwise direction also. Here, if you observe, this is nothing but the 0 degree. This is the 0 degree. Here, with respect to the 0 degree, if you observe, the motor is rotating 1.8 degrees. Suppose 1.8 degrees here. Okay, next it should be rotating towards 3.6 degrees. And next again, 5.4. Nothing but each step angle consisting of the 1.8 degrees, but the torque is to be not deviating. Torque is not deviating. If you observe, there is no disturbances in the torque lines. Okay. We are observing that the steady sinusoidal line only, sinusoidal signals in the form of sinusoidal signals only, the motor can be operating like this. Nothing but there is no torque disturbances. There is a stability manner, stable operating manner. Therefore, if the positioning deviation is less than plus or minus 1.8 degrees, the motor runs in open loop mode like stepping motor. If the positioning deviation is plus or minus 1.8 degrees or more, okay, the motor runs in a closed loop mode of operation. There is nothing but the importance. 1.8 degrees below the lesser than the step angle. Therefore, there is a possibility of open loop control system of stepping motor operation. The next one, it should be opposite, vice versa. That is a closed loop control operation. Next, alarm signal output in case of abnormality. This is also a very important one. There is a abnormal condition also happens. Yes, for any system operating in a manner, in a proper manner or a normal manner, but there is a problem of occurring abnormal condition. That is, if you observe, suppose if any system having occurring a fault condition, what should be happen automatically? The current parameter has been changed. That is nothing but related towards the overload value. Here, if an overload is applied continuously, an alarm signal is output. Overload has been applied towards the continuous manner. Even if it is the applied for the closed loop control system for the stepper motor, it nothing but it becomes towards the closed loop control of the stepping motor operation. But if the motor is under overload condition only, therefore what happens means there is an alarm signal can be happen. With respect to the alarm signal, therefore there is a problem that it can be occurring, can be determined. Okay, that it can be determined. That is nothing but the abnormal condition of the parameter. That is overload means here it is a current parameter. When the positioning is complete and end signal is output. When the positioning is complete, nothing but if you observe any display of the digital displays of any motor operation, if you observe start delay time means at what time period that the motor can be run, that is with the time period. Okay, start time period to turn on and also stop. Okay, that is nothing but the end. Okay, starting signal, ending signal. Previously, if you observe, this is the for the pulse. If you apply pulse command, here turn on time period. This is nothing but turn on time period. After that, you turn off time period. Nothing but start here and it is a stop or it is the end position. After that, we will again going to complete go for the another sequence of the start stop like that. This ensures the same level of reliability as a servo motor. We have the servo motor is also very good applications in the control systems. Here also, stepper motors also having the applications of control systems also, and also so many applications in the electronic, robotic and also on the electronic systems like that. If you observe, the reliability of the system motor can be improved. Okay, reliability. Next one, what about the comparison If you observe, we are having different types of motors, the stepper motors, that is the variable reluctance, permanent magnet, also the hybrid stepper motors. If you observe the advantages and also the types of stepper motors, in terms of the values which we considered here, it is a step angle. If you consider this is a step angle, the step angle for the permanent magnet, if you observe 7.5 degrees or larger value. 7.5 degrees or larger, nothing but below that we can't operate. We can't produce. Step angle below that the 7.5 degrees, we cannot produce. Like that. 7.5 degrees or more. Step angle can be required, that it can be rotated by the, that can it can be used by permanent magnet motor. Next, if you observe variable reluctance, 1.8 degrees or smaller, nothing but even it less than the 1.5 degree, 8 degrees, nothing but one degree, 0.6 degree, like that. Where the requirement, that it should be depend upon the requirement. Okay, variable reluctance motor. Next one, hybrid stepper motor. If you observe, hybrid stepper motor, sir, this is also same as that of the variable reluctance, 1.8 degrees or smaller. What about the output torque? The torque can be produced by the permanent magnet stepper motors is the moderate value. Variable reluctance is to be low and hybrid. Therefore, consider torque-related operation of the motors, of the stepper motors, means we can prefer first is to be hybrid, next one permanent magnet, and the next one is the variable reluctance. Therefore, the torque value can be reduced from high value to the low value. And next one, detent torque. Detent torque is to be within the permanent magnet, there is a problem. Detent torque, I explained previously also, when the coil is excited, first coil is excited, and the next coil is to be excited. At the next coil is excited, at the time, first coil is switched off, not de-energized. Nothing but before de-energization, there is an energy, that is a field energy, which is stored, okay, in the form of magnetic form. Therefore, there is a problem of to bring back the rotor position from initial to next level. That is nothing but the detent torque. Okay, here the detent torque happening in the permanent magnet motors, yes, and variable reluctance motor, no, but hybrid motors is also yes. Why? Because in these type of motors, permanent magnets and also hybrid motors, the rotor is a permanent magnet one. Therefore, the magnetic field is to be high compared to, within the air gap is high compared to the variable reluctance motor. The variable reluctance stepper motor is having the rotor is to be a normal silicon steel structured, silicon steel material, like that. Next one, pulse rate per speed, nothing but how many step angles can be taken per one revolution, that is nothing but pulse rate per speed. Is a low permanent magnet motors having the low pulse rate per speed, and it should be high, and also hybrid motors is also high. Next one, acceleration per response. From the permanent magnet, we are getting slow response, and variable reluctance rotors and also hybrid stepper motors also getting fast response. Next one, noise. Permanent magnet motors are quite low noise, or less noise, and variable reluctance and also these hybrid motors is also somewhat loud. And here hybrid motors is also very quiet operation. Next one, microstep. Microstepping means possibility of getting, if you observe the 7.5 degrees, microstepping is a very low value of the operation, step angle of the operation. That is nothing but the microstep. Here, there is a possibility of microstep of operation in a permanent magnet and also the hybrid stepper motors, but not in the variable motor. Next one, design. Permanent magnet motors is simple, variable reluctance is moderate, and hybrid motors it is very complex. That is nothing but the comparison of the stepper motors. Next one, what about the advantages only for the hybrid stepper motors? Here, if you observe that, the hybrid stepper motors are having that length of the step is smaller, and it can be produced as a greater torque, and provides a detent torque with the de-energized windings. The next one, high efficiency at lower speeds. The next one, lower stepping rate. These are the advantages that is having in the hybrid stepper motors. Next one, disadvantages. What type of disadvantages we are having within the hybrid stepper motor means high inertia. That is nothing but inertia of the rotor is to be high. Next one, the weight of the motor is more because of the presence of the rotor magnet. The rotor is having with a magnet, therefore the weight of the motor has been increased. If the magnetic strength is varied, the performance of the motor is affected. Magnetic strength is varied means if the permanent magnet rotor, nothing but the rotor is placing with the permanent magnet, sir. If the permanent magnetic strength, magnetic flux that it can be produced from the rotor, if it is changes, I think changes means if it is weakens the flux, therefore there is a problem of getting a performance on the performance of producing a torque value. Therefore, that is the problem. Next one, the cost of the hybrid motor is more as compared to the variable reactance motor. Here we are having that applications of in a hospitalities and also some more of electronic applications of driving the systems of PC systems, CNC applications. We are having the we are using this hybrid stepper motors. Therefore, from this hybrid stepper motors, we are completing this stepper motors unit. Then we go for the another unit. This is the complete unit of all the stepper motors. And we also discuss about some more of application of our sensors. We are having different types of sensors and also somewhat applications of the power driver circuits also in the next class. Thank you.